So again, as I have stated, let the criminal case be taken up by NBI, which we will fully respect kung ano yung magiging results. And if appropriate information will be filed in court, at sabi ko na nga, if warrants of arrest or commitment orders will be issued to our personnel, I'd be willing to surrender them to the courts. Second, on the investigation on the administrative side, you have already heard the Inspector General said his piece on the sequence of event that's going to undertake in order to file administrative case in against the nine policemen. Now, sir, I'd like to disabuse the minds of all those who are here today. Let us go on the intent of the committee. First, who triggered the shooting? Or probably, what triggered the first shot? Of course, that's iba yung appreciation, sir, pagdating sa criminal, kasi based on evidence yon. But ako, for one, I interviewed these nine policemen from Jolo kasi I feel responsible being the father of the PNP and tried to put myself on their shoes. What was the prevailing atmosphere at those times on June 29? So meron silang kwento. Tama yung sabi ni Senator Ontiveros that there's a drug angle, no? Kaya kung makita nyo kanina, repeatedly, sinabi ni Mandangan na ayoko nang ma-ambush ulit. On June, an operation was conducted na akala nila is may mag-surrender. Pero parang ang conclusion nila na frame up sila. And then, may namatayan tayo ng pulis doon, who is a police lieutenant, the team leader of the Provincial Drug Enforcement Unit of Jolo. And on that same incident, kasama ito si Mandangan. And Mandangan was even cornered, no? Good enough, dumating yung reinforcement, pero natamaan siya. So that was precisely, makita niyo yung expression ni Mandangan, ano yung sitwasyon at that time nakaharap niya doon yung ISU people. Anong nangyari before that? So merong angle na ganyan, no? So anyway, I don't need to elaborate on it. Pero ang sana ang isipin natin, merong ongoing also drug enforcement campaign ang Philippine National Police all throughout the country. And Jolo is not exempted to this. That's why part of my directive to my lower units is to really come up with link diagrams of all those people who are involved, and tungkol dito sa drugs. And Jolo is not exempted. There are drug pushers, there are drug users in Jolo. So yun sana yung, kaya makita nyo kung bakit na-involve itong tatlong piliyo. Hadn't it come into your mind, bakit nandyan sila? Bakit of interest sila? Di ba? Bakit? Kasi kung checkpoint lang yon, naghingi ng reinforcement, kung plain law enforcement yon, wala sanang hassle, no? Pero bakit nandoon si PDEU? Because they had some interest on those circumstances present on that day that happened. May interest din ng AFP. Meron kayong hinahanap na suicide bombers, no? That's why, sa conclusion dito sa lateral, as what has been concluded by the Joint Board of Inquiry, magaling tayo sa sulatan, no? Ang dami, since time pa ata ni Daipo, no? May maraming mga kasulatan nandito. Ang daming coordination, ang daming sulat, no? But sila na mismo sa BOI nagsabi na when it comes to tactical, require a different coordination. That's precisely the point why this thing happened. Now, yun yung lateral coordination. Now, second.
Mr. Chair,
Ma'am, allow me to finish because it will answer your question a while.
I, Mr. Chair.
Did somebody push for this to happen? Did somebody dictate to the policemen, patayin niyo yung mga army? Immediately after that, no, nung incident, nag-usap kami ni Chief of Staff Santos. And there were speculations of like that. Anong ni-require sa akin ni Chief of Staff? Bok, kunin natin lahat ng cellphones ng Siam para makita natin kung merong thread doon na talagang pinlano nila. Right away, the cellphones of these 9 people are in the custody of the crime laboratory for forensics. Because I also want to establish and free my mind that this is premeditated. Because they cannot excuse themselves pag nakita sa cellphone na pinag-usapan nila at pinlanuhan nila. But right away, we surrender the cellphone of the 9 people upon the request of the Chief of Staff. All the firearms were also surrendered. Now, I don't know, kasi ang alam ko, wala ni isang firearm na nasa armed force, na galing sa armed forces na napunta sa aming crime lab. Wala kaming hawak, no? Because the armed forces did not surrender it to the crime lab. For reasons maybe, as stated by Captain Tagire, na baka ASG, etc. So, okay, may excuse tayo bakit wala sa PNP. No? But these are material evidence also in the course of the criminal investigation of NBI. Diba? Although, narinig ko kanina, I don't know if it's right, that all the shells recovered were all accounted for PNP rifles. Well, that's on the criminal part. Now, again, probably last question series. Should we have more laws in protecting crime scene? Probably we should take a second look to that. No, that kasi ang warning ko lang sa lahat, the degree of proof that is required for a criminal conviction is proof beyond reasonable doubt. Once there is a very simple, a very slight doubt in the course of the investigation, you may lose the entire case. And tampering a crime scene could be very material. I'm not telling that it's a good part of the defense, but it can affect. That's why the preservation of the crime scene is very important. Kahit nga sa drugs eh, yung chain of custody pa lang, mabalik ka lang ng isa, wala na, acquitted na si, because the required proof is proof beyond reasonable doubt. Now, what are the innovations I did? No? Probably partly ito, yung sabi nga, 2 months na ito, wala pa ring administrative charge. When I sat down as officer in charge, on the usual 30-day pre-charge investigation, kasi sa PNP, pre-charge muna, there's probable cause, then you investigate. No? That's the time na mag-start yung role for an administrative case. Now, ang pre-charge, ni-reduce ko from 30 days to 10 days. Gusto ko sana 5 days. Pero umangal talaga yung Directorate for Investigation. Sabi, hindi siya talaga pwede. Okay, 10 days. So that's a very good reduction in terms of number of days you're supposed to resolve a case on a pre-charge level. Ano pang ginawa nating iba? By law or by regulation, you're supposed to receive administrative charges in 60 days. But that is, I said, the maximum. What is the minimum? 15 days. Kung magaling ka na summary hearing officer, actually you can rule upon an administrative charge for 15 days. So sabi ko, let's make the former minimum now the maximum. So now, in the PNP, you are supposed to resolve administrative charges in 15 days from the 60. So from the previous 90 days from pre-charge to actual hearing, we reduced it to 25. And that's the most that the PNP can do in terms of improving our administrative procedures. But again, on the criminal, ito na yung babalikan ko sa'yo. That the Philippine National Police, known din yan kay Chairman, we don't have the power to detain, no? Or even to place in custodial investigation our policemen. We cannot detain. Yung aming PNP detention cell, we cannot use that for the policemen. Not unless they are charged criminally. Why? Because ang powers lang ng Chief PNP is only restrictive custody. Ano ang sinasabi ng restrictive custody? Ilagay mo siya sa kampo gwardyahan, and when he goes out, he must be escorted. Yun lang ang kayang gawin ng chief PNP based on the regulations that we have. So probably way forward on legislation, dati kasi may power ang chief PNP to detain me. In 6975, I think, but that has been removed since then. Pwedeng ibalik lang, no? So that meron ng powers ang kahit si chief PNP lang, and later pwedeng ma-delegate on the power to detain. So in the entire perspective of the committee's hearing, these are my points na we should ponder upon. And we hope that the chairperson, this honorable committee, would see that as an future legislation. Thank you very much.